Missing person is Detective LaJoy.
Mark up every door you've knocked on, every area you've searched.
Mr. Anderson,
do you have any comment?
Press are going crazy over this.
Do you even have a suspect?
We're ruling nothing out.
They're saying that if he was alive, that you would have found him by now.
You have to trust me.
The convoluted plot of Eric, the Netflix series, stars Benedict Cumberbatch and Gaby Hoffman. It also involves a monster that is there or not there, a missing son, and a man going absolutely bonkers. I also imagine when I talk to them, it involved a detailed backstory.
Hugely important for me, and I think Gaby too, but I'll let her speak for herself, but for me, most of the work I do in prep is just understanding who the person is before you meet him on the page, especially with a writer as decent and brilliant and profoundly deep as Abby is, Abby Morgan. So it was understanding their relationship. We're right at the zenith of the wheels falling off of a 10-year marriage and a 9-year-old son and a career that's under threat, an identity that's under threat. There's a lot to need to understand.
Is there a diagnosis of why Eric sort of exists?
Well, in pathological terms, I suppose it's called a psychotic split, where something manifests outside of the person's psyche that is utterly real to that person and non-existent to everybody else. So we didn't want to pathologize it because there are a multiplicity of factors of causality. It's not just, oh, that person's autistic, that person's got depression, that person's has an obsession or an addiction. It's really complex. How could it not be? And so the story's really about understanding the whys and wherefores of how this originally came about and his way through it. And it sort of is totemic to the crises all around him. He's the individual that pinballs throughout the entire, all of the worlds and lives that we see pretty much in the story.
There's rumors about Sherlock, Benedict, anything?
No.
Would either of you be willing to do anything else in the world except act?
Yes.
Yeah.
I'm getting trained in September to be a death doula.
Gobsmacked.
But there are many other things I would be happy to do as well.
And Benedict, you?
I'd like to check out every program and become a surfer or a master of Japanese tea ceremonies or a wood surgeon, a tree surgeon. Yeah, or just work in conservation in any way, shape or form at the moment. That's a big calling I have at the moment. I'm doing a little bit, but.
Well, I'm both surprised and impressed. Thank you. Thank you both.
Thank you.
Thanks, Patrick.
Flicks with Patrick Stoner explores the craft and culture of filmmaking that enhance our communities for television stations and websites around the country.